Hello and a very warm welcome. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu is interacting with the director and staff of the Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital and Research Centre in Visag. He's also interacting with the regional director and the scientists of the BARC facilities. Let's cut across live.
To add in. And then I have attended the convocation of 29 universities also. Tomorrow I am attending another convocation in Bhubaneswar, AIIMS. Second sector is I've been visiting and interacting with scientists in the research and developmental activities of both the government as well as the private sector. I want to know what is happening in the research labs, research centers, what are the areas they are focusing, what is the experience they have, what are the problems and challenges they are facing, what is the output. And then impressing upon them about taking the lab to the land. It means people. The third sector is interacting with the farmers because farming is declining. And agriculture has become challenging. It's not sustainable. If the present trend comes, there will be again problem. Once upon a time, we used to depend on PL 480. In a country like India, which has got more than 130 crore population, I just saw today Andhra CM said that he wants to encourage population. I don't know whether the media has properly reported or not. You might have said it in different contexts also. 130 crore population. You cannot depend on imported food security. That's why a Singapore, a Kuwait can, but not India. You need to have homegrown. So I am trying to interact with the farmers because you have farmer suicide, you have farmers in distress, we have migration from agriculture to urban areas. People are preferring even government chaprasi job. There are four jobs also, rather than working in agriculture. That's a very, very disturbing trend. So that being the case, we have to interact with them, understand their problems in the field, and then try to address it through our system. The government of India is doing its best. State governments are doing, irrespective of political parties, every party is talking about it. The research is going on. So that also another sector. Then another one is the culture. The culture, the heritage, the traditions of India, the age old. Because India is a treasure of knowledge. It was called as Viswaguru. People from across the globe, they used to come and read here. Yuan Song and Pahian, the Chinese historians wrote about it also. And then you have a lot of experts. Even Aryabhatta, or you have Charaka, or Susruta. Then one, there are so many people in so many fields, I don't need not elaborate, I don't have that much time also. I don't want to take that much time here for you on this. So, but there is inherent knowledge and talent. It has to be taken out. It has to be little upgraded. It has to be little polished and encouraged. That also is an important aspect because culture, at the end of the day, is the way of living of the society. It can bring you happiness, or it can make you distress. The cultural center, the tradition, the culture which is given by our forefathers of thousands of years. India is one of the oldest civilizations. So everything done by our people earlier, it has some scientific value. All the sayings or whatever our elder people have advised, there is some message behind every saying because time tested. So keeping all these things in mind, I have been going around and also now trying to focus on voluntary sector. Because mere governmental effort alone will not suffice to change the society, to aid the society, to bring relief to the people. You need private sector also to enter in a big way. Private sector is really, I've seen, I really salute Homi Bhabha and also the Tatas for the great service they are doing in this particular sector. Nationwide, right? Even before independence. So there are many. And also there are a lot of other people who are working in different fields. Because unless the society gets involved, The change cannot come. PM has given a three-line advice: reform, perform and transform. The transformation of the nation. That is possible if there is a change of mindset. For that, mere government alone cannot do. But in our country, unfortunately, because of political system, we all are used to ek sab kaam sarkar karega, hum bekar baithe to chalega. Idantha government pani manakenduku vaallu chusukuntaru, MLA unnadu, corporate unnadu, mantri unnadu. Nee inti mundu pedakallu ettiyarante kuda ippudu corporate vastada? To remove the cow dung in front of your house, you are waiting for a corporate. That's an unfortunate state of affairs. Because I have been a minister in the rural development as well as in urban development. I have the practical knowledge of what is happening across the country. The time has come that the Prime Minister rightly taken initiatives for Swachh Bharat, Beti Bachao, Beti Padao, for drop, for crap. So many issues he is trying to motivate people, involve them. Because unless people participate, nothing can succeed. That's the experience. So you need NGOs, you need non-governmental organizations, you need people, individuals who are committed, who are ready to work as a mission without expecting any commission and not giving any remission of their duty. So you need such people also. So I am trying to meet them, greet them, talk to them, understand them. So friends, today this, as the idea of interaction is to know what is happening. These presentations that are made, that's why I was carefully hearing and seeing the presentations and trying to understand and enrich my knowledge. I also feel personally anybody at any level, either top level of political leadership or other leadership, they should also learn, because learning is a continuous process. And also we are seeing, we are living in an era of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. New opportunities are coming and new challenges also are coming. New diseases are coming. New problems are coming. So you need to find solutions to that, and then you have, as world is now becoming small, globe is becoming small village. So you need to know what is happening. What are the best practices? So that's why I tell everybody, first learn. Go on learning till the end. Even politicians also, mostly of course, they have to learn more. First learn and then earn. That's my advice to anybody. So learning is a continuous process. Even I feel that professors, lecturers, students, researchers, everybody must go through a refreshing course. Right from police constable to the police commissioner, to municipal corporator, to the ministers. Everybody must continuously have refreshing courses and they must upgrade their knowledge. Otherwise it will be totally outdated. My knowledge of my granddaughter in certain aspects is more than my knowledge. Though I have moved around the country for years together and then acquired so much field knowledge. Because, as I told you, science and technology, they are making progress. And Western countries, they are spending more money on research and development. And though we have wisdom and knowledge, we don't have enough resources till the other day. But now, fortunately, we are picking up. So all these things has to be kept in mind. That's why the Prime Minister, Albo Shastri, Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, they have given the three-line slogan, na? Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan, and then Jai Vignan. Vignan also, because science is for the betterment of the lives of the people. What is the ultimate aim of science and research? Is bettering the lives of the people, coming with new ideas. This incubation, this innovation, this stand-up, this start-up, those stand-up of early days is different. And we used to go to school late, teacher used to say stand-up on the bench. Now stand-up on your own legs. And then new ideas are coming. Ideas, research and ideas, they will definitely help people. Ease of doing business, ease of approvals, direct benefit transfer, or the GST, or the other transformation that's being put in, all are aimed in making the people's life more comfortable. And if it is really backed by a research study, that will be really more easy and you can accelerate the change. Homi Jahangir Baba was a great nuclear physicist and visionary who made important contribution to quantum theory and cosmic radiation and made India proud. Known as the father of Indian nuclear program, he has given the fillip to the India's nuclear power program. Today, climate change is the foremost global environmental concern. This is another challenge because we played the nature. Nature is playing back. What is happening in Kerala, what happened in other parts of the country, the tsunami, the hudhud, all these are effects, side effects and after effects and defects of our environmental policy. We should address it. That's why I'm nowadays, wherever I go, I'm telling all the youngsters, love and live with the nature. Love and live with the nature. We have forgotten nature and we have misbehaved with the nature. We are seeing the nuclear electricity is generated through very low carbon emitting technologies and can significantly reduce emission of greenhouse gases. It is considered to be safe, environment friendly, sustainable, reliable, efficient and economically viable source of electricity energy. It has the potential to meet the ever-increasing demands of energy in the country, especially at the time when we as a nation are making attempts to move beyond the polluting fossil fuels. I am told that 22 nuclear reactors are operational with a total installed capacity of 6,780 megawatts in India today. Earlier, the Union Cabinet has approved fleet mode construction of 10 indigenous nuclear reactors for additional 7,000 megawatts to be installed capacity. This will give a major boost to the domestic nuclear industry. Besides, what is significant is the pioneering work done by Indian scientists in the development of 500 MWE prototype East Breeder reactor, which forms a major element in India's three-stage nuclear power program. I appreciate the vision of the Department of Atomic Energy to promote safe, secure and sustainable nuclear energy through global partnership. We need to learn from those who have made advancements in the field but make efforts to bring down the cost. There is a famous Indian saying that wise men learn from others' experience and fools learn from their own experience. We are all wise men. We try to learn from others' experience also. Nuclear medicine has been a significant growth in India, particularly with the use of artificially produced radioisotopes for diagnostic, therapeutic and investigative purpose. I was informed that over 75 radioisotopes are produced for various applications and more than 10 lakh patients are benefited annually across 120 nuclear medicine centers and over 400 radio immunoassay labs. Dhruva reactor at BARC for medical isotope production ran at highest capacity in 2016 and 17. I am also extremely pleased to know that BARC has developed a process to extract physium isotope from liquid nuclear waste for making glass pencils used for in blood purification devices. I am told that it is the first of its kind in the world and India is the only country to have this technology in commercial domain. My compliments to scientists who have developed this technology. Dear friends, it is indeed a matter of serious concern for all of us that the incidence of cancer, the presentation was made by Dr. Lila and also Raghunathara, of the cancer for all of us, and the incidence of cancer is increasing steadily and posing a serious challenge to healthcare providers in the country. While the central and various state governments are taking various initiatives, including setting up of cancer care facilities, the country needs more exclusive cancer treatment centers to provide preventive, curative and palliative care programs to cancer patients. I am happy to learn that Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital and Research Centre is making efforts to make cancer care affordable. I was informed about their efforts in places like Visakhapatnam, Mohali, Guwahati, Varanasi, Kolkata and several other places through National Cancer Grid. The grid, which is one of the largest cancer networks in the world, connects cancer centres, research institutes, patient groups and NGOs in 137 locations across India. According to India Against Cancer, an initiative conceived by a group of medical doctors and researchers at the National Institute of Cancer Prevention and Research, NICPR, one woman dies of cervical cancer every 8 minutes in India. For every two women newly diagnosed with breast cancer, one woman dies of it in India. As many as 2,500 persons die every day due to tobacco-related disease in India. Smoking alone accounts for 1 in 5 deaths among men and 1 in 20 deaths among women, accounting for an estimated 9,30,000 deaths in 2010 alone. These figures are really disturbing. The top 5 cancers in men and women account to 47.2% of all cancers, and these cancers can be treated if they are detected early and treated at an early stage. This could significantly reduce the death rate from these cancers. According to the Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, approximately 12 to 13 lakh new cases of cancer are being diagnosed every year, along with an existing 25 to 30 lakh cancer cases at any given time in India. It is very sad that a majority of the cancers are being detected in advanced stages for the simple reason that most of the patients are not presenting themselves early. Inaccessibility, financial problems, ignorance are maybe the reasons. This situation needs to be reversed by creating awareness among the people on the need for regular medical checkups and screening awareness in general population about the big C will help in early diagnosis. It should be noted that many developed countries, including Europe and USA, have shown reduction in cancer spread due to effective screening program. We need to step up facilities both in urban and rural India so that people get to know the status of their health and take timely treatment. I feel it should be made mandatory. In the coming days, it's a gigantic task that everybody should go through medical examination and then update their medical condition. This should be done. Even for marriage also, it should be made mandatory. That's my personal opinion. And I hope that the country will start thinking on those lines. This can be done through mobile screening vans. Various factors, including modern lifestyle and increase in life expectancy, have also exposed the population to greater cancer risk. Increased use of tobacco is one of the main reasons, as is already stated. Research says India contributes to nearly 60% of head and neck cancer patients worldwide, and the number is expected to double by 2030. This is a very worrisome trend. Concrete steps need to be taken. Dear sisters and brothers, one of the major concerns for all stakeholders involved in the healthcare sector is the huge cost of cancer treatment. The treatment costs have to be brought down drastically, and this is where institutions like BARC, the Department of Atomic Energy, is doing its best. They all can play a vital role in developing low-cost technologies and equipment. As I was explaining today, just now I inaugurated one hospital. I have advised the doctors also. Doctors are not there to cure. They should also take the responsibility of counseling the people. Prevention is better than cure. We have to educate the people about the food habits, about the lifestyle. We are all eating junk food, stored food, frozen food. Our conditions are different. Our children have to be educated about this, because they are getting used to burger, pizza, something. Another weakness in our Indian system is that because of colonial rule, everybody's mind has been cheated. They have not only looted our property, but also cheated our minds. But they think everything foreign is great, everything local is not so great. We have to reinvent the past, and then we must go back to our roots and see the greatness of our civilization. Every food habit is linked with the seasons. In Telugu, cheptunnaru rutuvulato kani rutuvulu kuda kramam deppe endukante manushulu neethulu depparu kabatti tirigi malla mana value system, our traditions and culture has to be again brought in, including food habits also. మన పాత పచ్చళ్ళు, మన కూరగాయలు ఎంత రుచిగా ఉంటాయో, పాత చింతకాయ పచ్చడి తింటే కదా తెలిసేది. ది టామరిండ్ ఓల్డ్ చట్నీ ఆర్ ద గోంగూర ఆర్ ద ఆవకాయ ఆర్ ది అదర్ థింగ్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ చట్నీస్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఓడర్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ దేర్ సమ్ మెసేజ్. నువ్వు ఇంటి ముందు తులసి చెట్టు వేసినా, ఇంటి ముందు పేడకెళ్ళ కొట్టినా, ఇవి పుట్టు కౌడం కావాల్సి ఫ్రంట్ యువర్ హౌస్, దెర్ ఈస్ సమ్ మెసేజ్, సైంటిఫిక్ మెసేజ్. దిస్ ఈస్ టైమ్ టెస్టెడ్. దిస్ ద రీసెర్చ్ డన్ బై అవర్ పీపుల్ for thousands of years, and we are ignoring it and running behind the other fashions because the name were misread. The tomatoes produced here, sent there, and then cut into pieces, tomato ketchup, and then we eat the ketchup and end up with debt. Potatoes produced here, taken out, and then cut into pieces, then added some salt, and I can make it cheap, not a big thing. And then 400 rupees. Your tomato is 5 rupees, 10 rupees, and chips is 400 rupees. Really, it's a tragedy. We must come out of it. And we have to change our mindset. And even food also, you go to a restaurant, they give the names, new names every day, new name. You have your chicken, you have your Chettinadu chicken, your Andhra Natukodi Pulsu, Nelluru Chapala Pulsu, wonderful, beautiful, this thing. Chitchiguru, Chapalu, all. But temptation, or bodom, or chodom, anything, or new variety varieties. 65. You are 25 and you eat 65. And then you have Manchuria, Bulgaria, Somalia, even in India. Why can't you eat your Indian food? See, try to understand the climate. The body works and functions by dictation by the climate also. We have such a great advantage. Sometime back I went to London, the driver who was driving, he was saying, "Sir, good morning." I said, "Good morning, sir." "Good morning, sir. Today is sunny day." "Sunny day? What is sunny day? Is son's birthday?" No, sir. Not my son's birthday. "Sunny day, sir. Sunny, bright." I told him, "Poor fellow, India 365 days are sunny days." But we never harnessed the sun, the light. Now we started solar. There is abundant. Nature has given us so much. The greenery that was provided, we have destroyed successfully. Now we are planting trees. Your great-grandson, you will be able to enjoy it. Okay, even then, we should do it. Because our grandfathers and great-grandfathers have done it, now we have this, all this. We inherited this. Those days also. The greenery, the light, the pure water. All these things, we have to protect the nature. And then that's again lifestyle change, a sedentary lifestyle. You have to change, do some amount of exercise, the yoga. Yoga is an ancient Indian art. Yoga has not, some people also talk about yoga and say that is religious, sir. What is religious yoga? Some people say, "I have a problem with doing Surya Namaskara, sir." I said, "Do Chandra Namaskara, no problem. You have a problem with Surya, then do Chandra Namaskara." Who told you only Surya Namaskara? Unnecessary controversies. There is some weakness for our doubting everything ours, and believing everything from outside. Like we read, Robert Clive the Great in the history. Fellow who came here, looted us, cheated us, and we call him as great. And our Rana Pratap, our Sivaji, our Adur Sitaramaraju, our Prakasham Pantulu, our great scientists, our great people, engineers, Visvesraya. Because our educational system has ignored all these people and then focused more on outside. As I told you, we have nothing wrong in learning from others. Definitely we should learn. And we should admire intelligence and knowledge wherever it is there, wisdom is there. But at the same time, recognize own talent. And that's why, friends, what I suggest is that this institutions, both the institutions, the presentation made is very impressive. I'm happy that they're getting into their new campus. Once the campus is ready, by all means, I would like to come there. As I told you, I've been on a knowledge pilgrimage across the country. Because now I've become Uparashtrapati. Earlier I was in 24/7 into active life, and then some people have sent some questions also. Now, how do you find difference between that and this? You know, that was 24/7, free, meeting people, greeting people, talking with the people, walking with the people, eating with the people. Now only seeing the people. Because of this new responsibility. But still, I'm trying to move around and meet the people. The Vice President, of course, is a constitutional responsibility, assisting the President and also presiding over the upper house, House of Elders. You know how difficult it is to deal with elders. You must be experiencing it. And then you have other responsibilities. Of course, I am trying to fulfill those responsibilities. In this 1 year, I just now completed 1 year. friends have organized a get-together today. Yesterday they organized one in Vijayawada. Because that's one way of my meeting all of them. Otherwise, I can't meet people individually. That's another this thing. This, I have opened up the Vice President Nivas to the people. Anybody can come, including farmers. I try to interact with as many people as possible and pass on my ideas to the government. I am also holding national consultation on larger interest of public. Our first consultation was about strengthening the three-tier system, the municipality, the panchayat, and then state and the center, three-tier. Devolution of funds, functions and functionaries. I had a national consultation where ministers and other experts were there, states and center. Second consultation was consultation on sustainable agriculture in Pune with M.S. Swaminathan, with Mr. Sarath Pawar, Mr. Ashok Rahavati, lot of engineers, scientists, vice chancellors. Today we spent time. Like that, I am trying to interact with the people and hold consultation on larger issues and then pass on the information to Niti Aayog and also try to impress on the government also to go for policy changes. I am no more in politics. I have resigned from politics, retired from politics, but not tired from public life. That's why I am taking interest in other aspects also. Friends, the Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital and Tata Fundamentals research, I have been to Nano Center in Bengaluru. Wonderful things are happening. But I can tell you, lot of things are added, lot of new things are coming. But people of India today, particularly after this Prime Minister has come, they are now aspirational. Everybody is restive. Prime Minister also said, I am also restive. He also said, I am also restive. Because people want all these things to happen immediately, which have not happened earlier. 65% of the Indian population is below 35 years. It's a demographic dividend as well as a challenge also. Because youth, their aspirations, their ideas, their eagerness. And the poor also, after it, they have realized that they also want to become partners in the developmental story of the country. So that's why we have to focus on innovative methods, new ideas, new research, and find solutions to the problems, and also for reaching out to the people easily. That is also another major area. This biometrics, or this DBT, as I told you, all these things are, but still you need to come out with new ideas, because how do you reach people directly without any filterage, without leakage? How do you send the package to the last man? This is also a big challenge. For that also you need research. Once again, I would like to thank the Venkateswar Garu and also Dr. Gnadha Rao and others for organizing this theater. I would have been happy to come there, but I am told the work is on. So that's why I have invited all of you to come here. And I'm happy that the district administration also has worked to work out this program. And today I'm here. And I convey my best wishes to all of you, and particularly to the woman. Today is Varalakshmi Vratam. Andariki na subhakankshalu. Mahila, women also should be given importance. They should also be more and more seen. I'm happy whenever I go around the country. I was giving convocation address. Yesterday I gave convocation address for the School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada. Normally, because it's a long process of 1,600 people will be getting degrees and all. So they, because of the protocol, they make up the vice president to give it to 10 people, a top 10, 20, 30 gold medalists and all. To my happiness, wherever I go, I'm giving these gold medals. More than 60% of the recipients are girls. That's a very good development. Because they, girls, they, women, they focus more. They have less tension and more attention. And they learn also. Another good thing, yesterday I told them this on this farming, what is nature farming, zero budget. I said, use women, self-help groups. Your message will spread quickly. If it comes through here, it will go through more. Thank you very much. Namaskar, Jai Hind.
All right. right. So that was Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, who was interacting with the staff of the Homi Bhabha Cancer Hospital and Research Centre in Vizag. And he called upon the staff members to dedicate themselves to the welfare of the people. He said that the change cannot happen only with the government's efforts, but society will change with the voluntary efforts of all. He said that we all need NGOs, volunteers, individuals with a mission to bring about a change. He also called on professionals to pay more attention to research and development and preserve our culture, and also recognize and appreciate the talent within our country. And that's all in this broadcast. Thanks for watching. News and updates continue on your channel.